Hey there guys, welcome to Dinos Vault and welcome to my first drive review of the 2018 Mahindra XUV500. There is tons of information to share, so without wasting any time, let's dive straight into the review. Let's start with what all new this new model has on offer. What's immediately apparent is the new treatment given to the front grille. The front grille is more pronounced now and also gets a diamond studded treatment with the chrome inserts. The DRLs now get an eyebrow layout instead of the strip running across the headlamp cluster for the older model. Now, this new layout reminds us of the Audi SUVs to some extent, but it sure does look nice and premium. The powerful static bending projector headlamps light up the curves, thereby eliminating blind spots while tackling corners. We also get the cheetah-inspired fog lamp bezels that get some chrome garnish and look a lot more refreshing now. The muscular bonnet lines add all the muscle to the car. The new classy touches that this car gets by no means take away the aggressive demeanor of the car. The intimidation was always there right from the first gen model, but it was more on the radical and the sporty front. Now it feels like Mahindra have gone with a theme of sovereign aggression. It almost looks and feels like the mighty Thanos now, magnificent and supreme. Now coming to the profile, we get massive 18-inch diamond cut alloy wheels. Now please note that the 18-inch wheels are optional. We actually get 17-inch wheels as standard. Next, the side cladding also gets chrome inserts now, along with the window line also getting the chrome treatment. The XUV is undeniably now a chrome fest for all of the chrome lovers out there. At the back, we get all new wraparound split tail lamps that lend the car a more animalistic and upmarket feel when compared to the prior layout. We also get an aerodynamic rear spoiler along with tailgate chrome garnish, and we then have the twin exhaust pipes underscoring the car's powerful character. Stepping inside, we are welcomed by plush new interiors that well and truly take the premium factor of this car to a whole new level. The all new quilted tan leather seats are just as much as luxurious as they appear, both in terms of feel as well as comfort. The soft touch leather finish to the dash really exudes the premium quality that this new model is actually all about. The steering is perfectly sized to offer a good chunky feel. We do get steering mounted audio and phone controls, which has kind of become mandatory of late. The instrument cluster gets the same layout as prior. It was well ahead of its time when it was launched, so I guess it feels nice and modern and sporty even now. We then have the 7-inch touchscreen infotainment system that now features the world-renowned Archimist sound system. We get 4 speakers and 2 tweeters all around, and as a result, the sound quality is just as much as amazing, with heart-pounding bass and a completely immersive sounding experience. All the relevant info about the car is also displayed on the main screen, like distance to empty, the average mileage, the tire pressure monitoring system, the reversing camera, the service info, etc. The system supports only Android Auto for now. Doesn't support Apple CarPlay. Getting into the rear seat, we have ample amount of legroom and decent amount of headroom. 3 average size adults can feel comfortable in the second row seats. So, third row space is not bad. Best suited for kids, and adults can, you know, adjust for short trips within the city. But still, good job. We have dedicated AC vents. I'll show that later. We have dedicated AC vents for the third row passengers, and we also have cup holders and some storage net. So that's about it. Pretty well done third row seating for the new XUV. Talking about storage spaces, we get a dual glove box layout, as you can see here, which would always come in handy. We also get some space here up front on the dash, as you can see here. We get cup holders wherever necessary. We get some concealed storage underneath the driver's central armrest. Please note that this is a cooled storage compartment, so you can drop some cola cans in there. We also get bottle holders on all 4 doors, which is outstanding. Talking about the boot space, we hardly get any space, as you can see here, with all the 3 rows up. But fold down the 3rd row and we get 702 liters of boot space, which is quite huge. And just in case you are in the mood to carry your washing machine along with you, then you can fold down the 2nd row and we get over 1000 liters of storage, which is crazy. Now coming to the special features section, this car gets almost every feature that you can think of. We get engine start stop system, which comes coupled with the micro hybrid technology, as we've seen in other Mahindra vehicles before. The Mahindra fuel smart system with micro hybrid technology switches off the vehicle's engine after it has come to a complete halt. For example, if the vehicle comes to a halt at a traffic signal and you end up shifting to neutral, the engine will shut down automatically after 10 seconds. And once the signal turns green, all you need to do is press the clutch clutch pedal and the engine starts automatically and you can get a move on from there. Now this helps you save a lot of fuel, and apart from fuel efficiency, the system also has other advantages. It prevents the release of a considerable amount of carbon monoxide into the atmosphere, thereby mitigating the adverse effects of global warming. Apart from this, the car comes loaded with all the bells and whistles like automatic climate control, rain sensing wipers, automatic headlamps, passive keyless entry, cruise control, reverse parking sensors with a reversing camera, along with dynamic assist parking guidelines, 6-way power adjustable driver's seat to help you find the right seating posture. We also get power adjustable and power foldable outside rear view mirrors. We get tilt and telescopic steering and a host of other features. And yes, we also do get an electric sunroof, which is really cool. Also, just like the prior XUV models, we also get mood lighting or ambient lighting for the new XUV that looks super cool. Talking about the engine specs, we get one petrol and one diesel engine to choose from. The petrol variant gets the MHawk 2.2-liter turbocharged unit that puts out 140 bhp of max power at 4500 rpm and 320 Nm of max torque between 2000 to 3000 rpm. This comes mated to a 6-speed automatic gearbox. Now we do get an all-wheel drive option for the petrol variant as well. Now powering the diesel variant is the 2.2-liter MHawk diesel engine, which gets the 6th generation electronically controlled variable geometry turbocharger and as a result puts out 155 bhp of max power at 3750 rpm and 360 Nm of max torque between 1750 to 2800 rpm. Now this results in the new model putting out 15 bhp more power and 30 Nm of more torque. We get a 6-speed manual gearbox as well as a 6-speed automatic, and the great news is that we can get a diesel automatic right from the W7 variant priced at Rs 14.77 lakhs ex-showroom Hyderabad. We also have the option of getting an all-wheel drive variant for the manual as well as the automatic, which is outstanding. Now taking the car out for a drive, please note that I'm driving the top-end W11 diesel manual variant. Now I have driven all the generation-specific XUV500 models until now right from its launch, and believe me, I'm so glad Mahindra have constantly upgraded the vehicle, ironing out all the minor issues that they had to counter en route, and now I feel that they have brought this car to a point where it is almost flawless. First of all, it oozes the upmarket and premium feel via each and every element. Secondly, it makes you feel special the moment you step into the cabin with the leather finished dash, the ambient lighting, and just about everything that surrounds you in the cabin. The seats are well bolstered, and thanks to the 6-way power adjustable driver seat, you can find the right seating posture for yourself without much of a fuss. As you slot the car into gear and step on the gas, the car just lunges forward. There is no lag apparent whatsoever right off the mark. The bottom end torque is quite intense and immediate. The power delivery is quite smooth and linear. You do feel a bit of engine noise filtering in, but the NVH levels are far better controlled now compared to the prior versions. Also, the suspension is much better tuned such that the car glides over the potholes effortlessly. At the same time, the body roll is far better controlled on this new model compared to the prior models. The high-speed stability is amazing thanks to the larger 18-inch wheels. Also, the handling is extremely good thanks to the monocoque chassis. Now, quickly listing the advantages of a monocoque chassis over a ladder chassis or body-on-frame construction method. The monocoque chassis is a lighter design which results in better fuel efficiency. It offers better torsional stiffness, thereby offering much better performance. It also makes it easier for the company to incorporate crumple zones in a monocoque chassis, and monocoque chassis these days is usually used in luxury and performance oriented vehicles, whereas a ladder chassis is used for commercial and heavy duty vehicles. Now getting back to my driving experience, the clutch is a lot lighter now. The clutch for the earlier models was a little harder, almost to the point of giving you a leg workout, but now thankfully the clutch is light and effortless. Also, the brake sensitivity is much better. You just need to tap on the brake pedal and the car responds immediately by cutting down the speed. Even at speeds of up to 150 km per hour, the car feels nice and planted and confident. The turning radius surprisingly is quite short at just 5.6 meters for such a huge vehicle. The only thing that I wish were better was the gearbox. It is a long throw gearbox and it did not feel to be the smoothest of the units that I've experienced so far. Now since the car is new, I'm hoping that it will ease out with usage. Overall, the XUV delivers on all that you hope for from an SUV. It offers that commanding feel. The driving experience is quite engaging with good amount of bottom end torque. The engine is nice and responsive and refined. The body roll is well controlled and the NVH levels are also very well managed. Now, talking about the safety features, we get dual airbags and ABS with EBD as standard right from the base variant. We also get side and curtain airbags, which amount to 6 airbags for the top end variants, which is amazing. We get the electronic stability program with rollover mitigation, which prevents the car from rolling over under panic turning scenarios. We also get the hill hold and hill descent control, which really comes in handy while we are caught on slopes or inclines. We get disc brakes on all four wheels, which results in lesser pedal travel and better pedal feel. It also provides for better heat dissipation and reduced stopping distance overall. We also get this unique emergency call feature, wherein if the airbags are deployed, the system automatically calls 108 and also sends an SMS to your friends or relatives. Now, tank capacity is 70 liters. Ground clearance as per some online reports is 200 mm, although it isn't officially mentioned in the site. Mileage wise, the ARAI claim for the diesel manual is 15.4 kmpl, for the diesel automatic it is 14 kmpl, and for the petrol automatic it is 10.85 kmpl. Price ex showroom Hyderabad for the new 2018 XUV500 starts from ₹12.31 lakhs for the base variant and goes up to 18.97 lakhs for the top end diesel automatic all wheel drive variant. The price for the petrol automatic is ₹15.42 lakhs ex showroom. For the exact on-road price or any other query, you can call the number appearing on the screen currently. Special thanks to my well-wisher and good friend Mr. Ashwin from Automotive Manufacturers Mahindra Showroom for allowing me to review this car for you guys. Also thanks to Imran, Sandeep and Mallesh from the showroom for assisting me with the shoot. Well, I guess this wraps up my review of the XUV500 2018 model. I just hope you found this video useful. Until next time, this is Dino saying ciao. Take care, God bless and drive safe.